Summer day, still make you wonder. Should've been you and me, but never say never. We can settle down with him, you be settling. Mama, why you waste your time?
Let's talk about you as a musician and an actor. Now, I know I've watched and listened to a lot of your previous interviews, and you define yourself as a musician. You can play the piano, and the guitar, so you're very talented. Did you ever think, with all of the success of Power, that actually maybe that's not your destiny? Maybe your destiny is performing in front of the camera?
I knew my destiny was to just entertain. I knew that, you know, I was given the ability to do whatever I really put my mind to. And again, very few people have been able to change the culture in that way, with a Harry Belafonte, a Jamie Foxx, you know, even a 50, you know, people that can do both very successfully and create. And that's, I feel like I'm along that lineage. And I never wanted to put myself in a box. It's just Power just happened to pop first. That's the funny thing. I've been doing music way before acting came about. But Power popped first, and now people are seeing what I truly do. And it brought to my attention that, like, I played a character who is a villain, but now you have a record that's making people dance. Mm. That versatility, you know, is very, very rare, and I don't take it for granted.
Wait. Before you hang up, please, let me just talk to you. Let me explain what happened.
He'll call you back.
What are you doing here, man? You shouldn't be here.
I shouldn't be here. I gotta find Tariq. But Raina said you know some of these people he'd been some named Slim?
Wait, what do you mean, find Tariq?
He's missing, Dre. They asked Tasha for money. So you tell me, who is Slim?
I told you to have a close eye on the kid. You told me it was family business. You told me to fall back.
Do you know what he is or not?
So going forward, of course, we've got a new season of Power coming up.
Yes.
And then there are some kind of franchises that are branching out from Power. Do you think now, when your agent comes to you with scripts, will you be careful of, you know, what you pick? You're not just going to be going for the coin.
No, you can't. You know, it's bigger than money now. It's about legacy. You know, and going from a show like Power, I can't do anything that is here, you know, no matter how much money, you know. I have to protect the brand, you know, and I'm all about integrity, all about, like, the art, and it has to make sense, it has to be good, and money doesn't drive, it's important, but it doesn't drive my decisions, you know. I think that if it feels right and it's something that makes sense, I'd love to do it.
It's all good. It'll get dealt with quick.
I got a plan, Kay.
What the hell is Kanan doing here?
We're working together.
Dre's our enemy.
Emma, listen, I love Power. My husband loves Power. Yeah. All of my people love Power. Yeah. But some of the scenes are really, really violent.
Yeah.
Do you ever worry about that? You know, when you become a performer and a creative artist, what you put out is very important because you have a lot of fans.
Yeah.
Is that ever a worry? You ever reading some scripts and like, damn, did Dre really do that?
Oh, I did that six times. Like, oh my God, I gotta do this? But again, it's part of the story. And it's a beautifully written story.
Mm.
You know what I mean? So like, I just play my part in it. And as an actor, you dream of just making people feel something as an actor. So when you make them say, why did you do that? And da, 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 you've done your job. You've done your job. And it begets more money and more jobs when people can see that you affect them. So we use the same formula for music. And we wanted to make records that made people feel. When you feel, you hear Lover, and it's like, oh, that's mine. And you naturally do that because it just, sonically and energy-wise, it just fits in a place that's refreshing.
Show you love, wish I can make you know it.
Baby, you need to know it. Where do you go?
What about Nigeria, being back home?
Yeah.
Do you consider Nigeria?
Oh, yeah, for sure. Yeah.
And what about your music and your fans there? How do you think they've received it?
I think people are championing it because I feel like it's like a voice, you know, it's someone that's saying he's one of us and he hasn't forgotten us and he's bringing us to a place where, you know, like the world needs to know how powerful we are. And so I take pride in that, you know, even now that's why I make sure I wear, you know, colors that, you know, colors, you know, because I take pride in all of it because I want people to understand that. It's a movement, and we are the source. I mean, we're the source of everything, and yeah, I think we're very good.
Who are you a fan of? I know that you've toured with Wizkid.
Yes.
When Wizkid was still, you know, very kind of unknown.
Yeah.
Now he's a massive superstar.
Yeah.
Who kind of inspires you in Nigeria?
Wiz. I say Wiz because he is one of the most humble superstars, you know, and he's a living legend. Davido as well, like he's special too. Burna Boy is special, Malik is dope, you know, so like there's a lot of us that are just changing the culture.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a beautiful thing to see, you know. I feel like with Wiz, he's personally the one I connect with because I spent some time with him, you know, and I saw like how kind of a person he is. The gift and the talent is given, you know, but what you do with it is what I'm impressed by.
Juju.